In the museums around the world, the ancient megalodon sharks were considered as the dominant predators in the ocean through the prehistoric ages. With their huge size and enormous jaws, they were capable of hunting ancient whales, the ancestors of modern blue whales. Although megalodons are now considered extinct as a result of extreme weather and climate change, their descendants, modern sharks, still have the outstanding hunting abilities of their ancestors. Present in oceans across the world, there are at least 480 different shark species that have been discovered by science so far. Around half of them are less than 1 meter long, such as lantern sharks, with an average length of 20 centimeters. At the other end of the scale, whale sharks, the largest shark species, are around 12 meters in length. Although they're huge, they are in fact completely harmless to humans. Other than their differing sizes, the shape of the bodies and heads of sharks are also diverse, from the strange head of the hammerhead shark to the flat body of the angel shark. But the great white shark is still the most special, the king of the ocean. Unlike other species, the great white shark's eggs are stored in the mother's uterus, and the baby will grow up thanks to the nutrients inside. From 6 months to 11 months inside the mother, when the nutrients in the eggs run out, the baby sharks have fully developed and could come out. However, to reach a safe size in the wild, they have to eat unhatched eggs to continue developing before being officially born. From that moment, they will stay with their mother in the short time before starting a journey to become a lone predator. The main food in this period will be some other small sharks and common coastal fishes. This process will last until the babies reach a length of nearly 4 meters. They will then begin to hunt the marine mammals that provide a lot of energy-rich fats, like sea lions and seals. From their hunt, we will understand why the great white shark is called the perfect hunting machine. Phase 1 – Prey Detection. Under the water, seals will emit a mixture of smells, including their own body oil and blood from their food. It's like an invitation for the great white shark to come. Then, the most acute sense of the shark is activated – smell. The water flows containing the mixture of smells goes through the nostrils into the olfactory chamber in their head, where there are many layers acting as filters, helping to increase the area of contact with that mixture and also the sensitivity of smell. This chamber helps the shark to detect the specific smells of prey and also send signals to the brain, where the characteristics of that prey can be analyzed and calculated. The shark then tracks its prey through those smelly water flows to begin the hunt for a delicious meal. Phase 2 – Prey Navigation. The swimming habits of seals create sound waves that spread throughout the surrounding water. Those sound waves will be transmitted to the two ears on top of the shark's head and travel down into the inner ear on each side of their head. After that, the sound waves cause vibrations in the thousands of sensors lined up like a wall inside the ear, creating signal pulses to the brain. In addition, the lateral line with the tiny holes along the shark's body can hear every movement from the seals by sensing the vibrations in the water. Inside, thousands of sensors, like those in the inner ear, can detect the slightest changes in the water from hundreds of meters away. Just like what happens in the inner ear, these highly sensitive sensors are vibrated to transmit signals to the brain for further analysis. Therefore, the perfect combination of hearing and vibration sensing allows sharks to calculate the size, distance, and direction of their prey. Phase 3 – Locking on to the target. Thanks to that perfect combination, the shark starts to move towards the seal island, where the party is about to begin. But nothing is easy. As it gets closer to the island, the light and visibility in the water around the island starts to get very limited. The structure of the shark's eyes holds the secret to enhance eyesight and adapt to the very fast movements of the prey. The lens in the shark's eye can be moved into different positions, allowing them to clearly see prey at varying distances. But what makes the big difference is behind the eyes. A reflected crystal layer is located behind the retina. In normal conditions, when the light is bright, this layer of crystals acts like sunglasses to protect the nerve cells in the eye from UV rays. But in poor light or at night, the crystal layer will be adjusted to rotate and reflect the light rays to amplify the light level inside and transmit images of the prey to the brain. That incredible structure helps sharks to find and kill their prey easily, whether it's in daylight hours or at night. When the shark has locked onto the targeted prey in front of it, the front fin will be lowered, the caudal fin is made ready to be activated, and the eyes roll back to reveal the eye protection layer and defend the eyes from any fight back from the prey. And the rest depends on the sixth sense located in the tiny holes at the tip of the nose, helping the shark to exactly determine the position of the prey, even if it can't see anything. Everything is ready for the decisive moment to knock down the prey with just one fatal bite. Unfortunately, the millions of species of sharks across the world's oceans are caught and brought to huge chain production facilities to turn them into commercial products that bring large profits to black market traders and illegal activities. Their fins are used to make soup in the Asian markets, their skin is used for decoration, and the oil in their liver is extracted to make medicine. Such overhunting could lead to the extinction of some shark species and serious consequences for the ocean environment. Therefore, protecting sharks is an efficient way for us to protect the environment and also to protect ourselves.